गुड आफ्टरनून गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स आई एम ऑडिबल
यस सर गुड आफ्टरनून सर
ओके थैंक यू
गुड आफ्टरनून सर
वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून ओके सो इन द यस्टरडे क्लास So we discuss about the first block about the features of the Telangana and demographic features. Okay, demographic features including the human resource that is health related and what is called education related. So actually, the first block. Whatever the things we discussed in yesterday class, we can say this is the brief introduction of the whole syllabus, whole Telangana economy. See, please, here, if anybody want or interested to write the competitive exams. Particularly group 1 or group 2, this subject is very important. Whatever the things I am giving the data and the brief report about this Telangana economy, it is very important. See, actually, you may have your textbook with you, but here, what I am doing now, in addition to that, I am adding the latest data for you. I am adding latest data, the including economic survey. In your textbook, which was given by this Ambedkar Open University, the data will be there up to 2018-19 only. But whatever I am giving the data here, see, the data is there up to 2020-21 also. Okay, up to 2020-21 data also. That is the latest data I am giving. That's why for those who are preparing for the competitive exam, those who want to prepare the competitive exam in the future, so this, whatever the data I am giving, this is very, very useful for you. Okay, here we are going to be start the second block. Here, whatever we discuss in the first block, the same topics we are going to be discuss in the detailed manner in the second block. This is a GSDP. Okay, poverty and unemployment. These are the topics we discussed already in the last class in the name of the features of the Telangana economy. But in the second block, again these topics were there. Here we have to discuss in the detailed manner. Okay, with the detailed manner we have to discuss. In this particular block, that is called second block, we have two units, that is unit 4 and unit 5. In the unit 4, we are going to discuss the growth trends in the gross state domestic product and per capita income in Telangana. Trend or nothing but how it is changing. What are the factors are influencing to change that trend? That is, we have to see. At the same time, in the unit 5, we are going to see what is poverty. What are the types of the poverty? And how the poverty is measuring? And what is the poverty? How much poverty ratio was there? Like that, what is unemployment? What are the types of the unemployment? And how we can measure the unemployment and the status of unemployment in the state? Okay, this is different type of the concept we are going to discuss in today's class. Okay, these are the two questions we can see today. Okay, here, what is GSBP, first of all? Okay, what is GSBP? GSDP, that is cross, okay, state, what is known as domestic called product. Okay, cross state domestic product. Stula Rashtra Desiyotpatti under the name. Stula Rashtra Desiyotpatti and a center. Cross state domestic product. And okay, of course, I given the brief definition in the last class, that is yesterday class. Once again, for the sake of the continuation, I'm repeating. The cross state domestic product. Nothing but it is the in 1 year. Okay, in 1 year. Already I told you 1 year, nothing but it is a financial year. Okay, financial year. Financial year, nothing but April to March. April to March. During this particular period of time, that is 1 year. It is a total value, value nothing, price, total value of final goods, okay, final goods and services, total value of the final goods and services produced by one country be one. So produced by one state people of one state, people within the boundary of the state. Take for example, we are talking about Telangana state. In Telangana state, in Telangana boundary, total how many people are there in this boundary? And what is the production produced by these people? And what is the value of that production is called GSDP. Okay, yeah, since we are talking about the people who are there in boundary. Okay, people who are there in the boundary and their production, that production value is called GSDP. So people who are there in the boundary, all their production, that production value is called GSDP. So within this boundary, there may be people of Telangana or people of other states. Even other state people also may be. Take for example, I am the person, I am working in Telangana, I am staying in Hyderabad. Suppose I am from Gujarat. Okay, originally I am from Andhra Pradesh actually. Okay, my native place is Andhra Pradesh. But working in Hyderabad, that is staying in Telangana. So since I am there within the boundary of the Telangana state, whatever the production produced by myself, my production value will be considered as a Telangana state income only. Telangana state income only. Suppose one Telangana person is working in Andhra Pradesh and getting the income. That income will include Andhra Pradesh GSDP, not in Telangana income. So here the people who are there within the boundary of the Telangana. So that people, how much they are producing goods and services, that goods and services value will be considered as Telangana GSDP. So means here in Telangana GSDP, okay, in Telangana GSDP, here other state people, okay, other state people income will included in Telangana state GSDP. Okay, if any Telangana people working other than Telangana state region, Telangana state boundary, so their income not included. Okay, not included in the Telangana GSDP. D and the domestic nothing but boundary. Within the boundary, who are there, that income will be included in the GSDP. That's all. Even though they are not, they may be related to Telangana people, but if they are not in our boundary, if they are not in the Telangana boundary, whatever the production they are producing by, that income is not at all included in the Telangana GSDP. Okay, please remember this point whenever you are talking about this GSDP. It is not only for Telangana, it is applicable for any state, the concept wise. Okay, in Telangana, what is the growth rate of the GSDP? How much GSDP was there yesterday? We discussed for the last years, for 2019-20 and 2020-21, how much GSDP was there with the current year price and the base year price, how much it was there, I discussed yesterday. But here, today's topic is how it was changing, how it was increasing in the last years. Okay, here, based on available data in the economic survey, we've taken the data from 2012-13 onwards. Because before the formation of the Telangana state, we've taken around 3 years. So before formation of the Telangana, how can we take the income of the Telangana? Already I told you in the last class. So before formation of the Telangana state, the Telangana nothing but Telangana region in Andhra Pradesh. In the United Andhra Pradesh, we have the three major regions. That is Telangana, Rayalaseema and Coastal Andhra. So whatever the income is generated from the Telangana region including Hyderabad, that income will be called Telangana income. So that is calling as a Telangana state income later on. So that's why before 2014, Telangana state income nothing but Telangana region income in the total Andhra Pradesh. Okay, that was considered as a Telangana state income. So in 2012-13, the GSDP with the current year price, what is the current year price? For which year you are estimating the income, that year prices is known as the current year price. What is the base year? To estimate all this type of the income, the government will decide one particular year. With that particular year, the government will estimate the income, that year prices is known as the base year. At present, we have 2011-12 is called base year. 2011-12 is called base year. According to the 2011-12 only, so we are running this account. So according to the current year price, it was 11.7% in 2012-13, but whereas with the base year price, it was only 3%. Always base year price, growth rate, values, everything will be lesser than the current year price, because current year price nothing but latest, but base year nothing but, we can say, one year previous, present. If you take current year 2020-21, base is 2011-12. So automatically, if we estimated the prices with 2011-12, then definitely the value will be less. Okay, with the base year, the growth rate was 3%. But in 2013-14, The growth rate with the current year price was 12.4%, whereas the with the base year it was 5.4%. In 2014-15, the growth rate with the current year was 12%, but whereas with the base year price it was 6.8%. Okay, in 2015-16, the growth rate with the current year price 14.2%, whereas with the base year price it was 11.6%. 11.6%. Okay, with the 2016-17, it is 13.9%. With the base year, it was 9.3%. 17-18, it was 13.9%, same continued. But with the base year, it was 9.7%. In 2018-19, the growth rate with GST was 13.4%. But with the base year price, it was 8.3%. In 2019-20, the current year growth rate was 13.5%, but whereas base year price was 7.9%. In 2020-21, the growth rate with the current year price was 1.3%. In the base year, it was minus 1.3%. So that was the negative growth rate because of this pandemic season. Okay, because of this corona effect. At least the Telangana state growth is a little bit better than the other states. In all India level, the growth rate was in all India level was almost it is like minus 7%. Minus 7%. But in Telangana, it is a negative growth rate. It is the minus, but it is less. That is minus 1.3%. Okay, yeah. See, before 2014, the growth rate was around 12%. It may be 11.7%, 12.4%, 12%. But after 2014, it is 14% of what you do. Except 2020-21, in the remaining all years, it is nearly 14%. That means before the formation of the Telangana state, the growth rate with the current year price was around 12%. But after the formation of the Telangana state, the growth rate was around 14%. So after the formation of the Telangana state income is developing very fastly, very rapidly. Based on this data, we can identify. So, but if you see this, the growth rate with the base year price, after the formation of Telangana state, it is very high, except the last year. Before the formation of Telangana state is 3, 5, 6, something like that. But after the formation of Telangana state is, it is like 11%, 9%, 10%, something like that. It is. So, whatever the value we are estimating with the base year price, that is called real growth rate. Okay, real growth rate. See, remember that if any values, we are talking about the growth rate now, yeah? So if we say growth rate of GSDP with base year price, okay, base year price nothing but 2011-12 at present. So that is known as real growth rate. Okay, real growth rate. That is called real income. So which is called a real income or real growth rate, real GSDP growth rate. So if you say growth rate with the current year price, okay, current year price, that is known as the nominal growth rate. Nominal growth rate. So always the real growth rate is very important. The nominal growth rate is depending on the inflation. If the prices will increase, the value of the production may increase without increase the production also. Because the prices are increasing. So that is inflation effect. But if, whereas in the real GDP, if that is increasing nothing but the production is increasing. The increasing the production always very, very important. That is very important. That is what we can say about this trends of this GSDP, how they are changing. Okay, like that, this is the status of the what is called per capita income. What is the per capita income? Yesterday I given the definition. Per capita income is nothing but average income of the people. Average income of the state people, that is Telangana state. The per head income of Telangana state is known as the per capita income of Telangana state. So it is in all India level. In all India level means average income of all people in the country. All people income is called national income. Total population is called population. National income divided by population is known as the per capita income in the all India level. Here the Telangana state income. Okay, Telangana state income divided by population of the Telangana state is nothing but state per capita income. How the per capita income is increasing? How the per capita income is changing? How the per capita income changes is known as a trend. Trend nothing but how it is changing. Okay, if you see, this is the current year price, both India level and state level. In 2012-13, in Telangana state, the per capita income was 10.8% it was increased. It was increased 10.8% when compared with last year. Okay, when compared with last year, it was increased 10.8%. Okay, but whereas in India, it was increased 11.9%. In 2013-14, in Telangana, it was 11.5%. In India, it was increased 11%. In 2014-15, in Telangana, per capita income was increased with 10.6%. In India, it was increased 9.5%. In 2015-16, Telangana, per capita income, Telangana, it was increased 13.5%. But whereas, in India level, it was increased 9.4%. Okay, in 2016-17, in Telangana, per capita income was increased 13.2%, whereas in India, it was increased 10.6%. Okay, in 2017-18, per capita income Telangana was increased 12.5%. Okay, in India, it was increased 9.9%. So, in 2018-19, in Telangana, it was increased 12.1%. It is increased 9.3% in all India level. In 2019-20, the per capita income Telangana was increased 12.3%. In India, it was increased only 6.6%. In 2020-21, during this pandemic season, because of this corona effect, since there was a negative growth rate, average income also, it was very less. 0.6%, it is the positive value. But in India, it was in the negative value. So minus 4.5%, that is nearly minus 5.5% was decreased. Negative growth rate, nothing but compared with the last year, the per capita income, that is the average income of all the people was decreased. This is the situation. Okay, this is the situation of the what is called per capita income. It may be in Telangana or it may be in India. So in all years except 2013-14. Except 2013-14, in all years, Telangana state per capita income is more than the what is called India's per capita income. In the, when compared with the national level, our per capita income is better. Telangana state per capita income is better than the national level. So the economic performance in Telangana is better than the what is called other states. So this is the what is called about this particular aspect of the per capita income on GSDP. So this GSDP may be NSDP, which is called state income, NSDP nothing but stating the how you will get the NSDP. NSDP nothing but GSDP minus depreciation. I told you in yesterday class. And the per capita income of Telangana state. So which is called state per capita income. So it may be state per capita income, it may be NSDP, that is net state domestic product and gross state domestic product. All are increasing. All are increasing. They are in the progressive. But when compared with before the formation of the Telangana state, after the formation of the Telangana state, all these are having the good progress. There is a positive progress. There is a betterment here in the economic development of the Telangana state after the formation of the state. The reason is we are consuming our resources in this place only. But in the United Andhra Pradesh, the resources may be exploited by other regions. But here, whatever the resources are available in Telangana region, all the resources are utilizing in this place only. And because of the development of Hyderabad, maybe before also and after the formation of Telangana state also, it is developing very rapidly. In the United Andhra Pradesh also, it was developed, no doubt. But after the formation of Telangana state also, it is developing like anything. This Hyderabad state, it is developing as a world-class city. World-class city. So because of the development of this Hyderabad city, in around Hyderabad city, all the IT companies were established in this area. Okay, because of this IT sector, IT services, the income is coming from the IT sector is very, very high. And agriculture we developed. Okay, yeah. So if you see the government report, because of the construction of the irrigation projects like Kaleswaram, okay, one of the most important projects. After the construction of this Kaleswaram project in Telangana state, the Telangana state government is able to provide the irrigation facilities for more than 1 crore acres of the land in Telangana state. So because of this reason, today Telangana is one of the highest producing food grains state in the country. One of the highest food grains producing state in the country. Because agriculture is developed. Industry already developed, again it is developing. Service sector, particularly IT sector, it was developing like anything. Along with Hyderabad, Warangal, Karimnagar, Nizamabad, Khammam, remaining all the cities are developing. Because of special economic zones, establishment of Telangana, industrial corridors, NIMS, industrial development, particularly drugs, pharma industry. So because of all the development of your industries in this region, agriculture income is increasing, industrial sector income is increasing, service sector income is increasing. So because of the development of all these aspects, we can say that the Telangana state is developing like anything. The Telangana state is in the progressive condition. These are the reason why the Telangana state is moving upwards. So this is the if they will ask the question that write the trends of the GSDP growth in Telangana state, you have to give that data and you have to give the explanation. Data, all this data may not that much important, but yet please remember, whenever you are writing this data, at least last 2-3 years data, you please try to remember the examination factor. Try to write data in the exam, at least last 3. The total data may not be required, at least last 2. At least, if you write the whole thing, it is very good, no doubt other. But at least, so the latest information, so you please try to do in the examination point of view. So that is about the trends. Okay, trends in the growth of GSDP and per capita income in Telangana state. But then in this particular chapter, along with this trends in GSDP and per capita income, so we have one more concept like what is called, so this one, poverty and unemployment. poverty and unemployment. Poverty means what is poverty? Even yesterday also I given the brief introduction about the poverty. What is poverty? The person who is not able to meet the basic requirement like food, shelter, cloth, they will come under the below poverty line, they will call poor people. The basis of the intensity of the poverty, this poverty was divided into these two categories. One is absolute poverty and another one is relative poverty. Okay, absolute poverty and relative poverty. So this absolute poverty, nothing but this is the called poverty actually. The relative poverty is not that much intensity. That is not that much priority. Okay, but absolute poverty is very dangerous for the people. Because in case of this absolute poverty, absolute poverty is a condition are characterized by severe deprivation. More problem, more dangerous. Severe deprivation. And deprivation, they are not able to meet the basic human needs. Okay, basic human needs like food, safe drinking water, sanitation facilities, health facilities, shelter, education, information, cloth, all this. So these are the basic needs today, no? If the people are not able to get these basic needs at least, these are the basic needs, human basic needs. So that person called absolute poverty people, absolute poor people. Okay, that is called generally poverty. But here, the relative poverty means it is a comparison. Comparison. When comparison between rich and poor, the lower income group people are poorer than the higher income group people. Suppose A is getting a 10,000 rupees income per month. A is getting 10,000 rupees income per month. B is getting a 1 lakh rupees income per month. Okay, per month. With 10,000 rupees, can be, at least he can meet his basic requirement. So, the A is poor when compared with B because A is having a lower income than the B. But if both are not poor people, both are can be able to meet the basic requirement. But when the lower income group people are the poorer people than the higher income group people. Higher income group people. That is called a relative poverty. That's why I told you this is not that much danger. Relative poverty, nothing but it is not a dangerous. So it will be not a danger for the person. But absolute poverty is very dangerous because the person is not able to meet his basic requirement. No? That is his problem. So here, this poverty is going to be measured. The poverty is going to measure with two methods. One is URP and another is MRP. Okay, URP and what is called MRP. URP nothing but uniform recall period. MRP nothing but a mixed reform or recall, or we can say reference period. Recall or reference. In some textbooks, you can say reference. In some textbooks, you call recall. Okay, reference or recall. Uniform recall period, mixed recall period. Uniform reference period, mixed reference period. So these are the two methods they are following to what is called construct the poverty. To construct the what is called poverty. URP nothing but It is based on the consumption expenditure. Consumption expenditure for 30 days, reference period of them is taken for all the commodities. Consumption. I will tell how much consumption. The different period to period it was changed. It is called monthly per capita expenditure. So a monthly per capita expenditure, MPCE. So nothing but monthly per month, per capita average consumption expenditure. So each and every person and an average how much they are spending money to purchase the goods and services to satisfy his basic requirement is called monthly per capita expenditure. So this monthly per capita expenditure, if you take the reference period for the 30 days, that is called uniform reference period. So in the mixed reference period, here, 1 year consumption expenditure are taking on the five items. What are the five items? One is cloth. Second is footwear. Third is expenditure on the education. Institutional hospital, not by the Gadi, institutional hospitals, and durable goods. These are the five items. Durable goods. So these are the goods. These are the goods are utilizing the people for the long period, like fridge, AC, fan. All these are called durable goods. So whatever the amount is spending on these five items are taking for it. 1 year, 1 year reference, that is 365 days reference period, and the remaining all items we are taking the expenditure for the 30 days for the remaining items. So 365 days expenditure on five items, these are the five items, and the remaining 30 days expenditure for our remaining all items are taking. So by combinedly taking these two is known as the mixed. So by combinedly taking these two is known as the mixed. 1 year plus 1 month. 1 year for 1 year for only five commodities and 30 days for all the commodities. So by mixing these two references, 1 year plus 1 month, if we measure the poverty, that is called mixed recall period or mixed up what is called a reference period. Mixed recall, mixed reference period. Okay, based on these references, the Suresh Tendulkar, not a Sachin Tendulkar, Suresh Tendulkar was the one of the economists. During 2011-12, he was appointed the chairman to estimate the poverty in India by the government. So he given the report to estimate, he suggested some methodology to measure the poverty in the country. So whatever the method suggested by Suresh Tendulkar will be considered as a Suresh Tendulkar report. Okay, according to the Tendulkar report in 2011-12, in the rural area, monthly per capita expenditure was considered as 860 rupees. In the urban area, it was considered as 1009. In Telangana, I'm not talking about India, I'm talking about Telangana, please remember. So this is developed for Telangana state. So 860 rupees, 1009. 860 for rural area, 1009 for the urban area. This is the monthly per capita expenditure. That means those who are not able to spend it, this 860 rupees in the rural areas per month to satisfy the desires is known as the poor people. In the urban area, those who are not able to spend this 1009 rupees are not able to spend to satisfy the desires is known as the poor people in the urban area. So that means if any person is spending more than 860 rupees in the rural area, they will not be poor people. If any person is spending more than 1009 rupees in the urban area to satisfy the requirement, that person is not considered as a poor people. So like that, this is called monthly per capita expenditure. Based on this monthly per capita expenditure, this is the latest data. Before that, it was there in different, but I'm talking about the latest. After that, there is no in the same year, there is one more Rangarajan committee. I will come. After the Rangarajan committee, in 2014, actually BJP government came. After the BJP government came, since 2014, it did not measure what is poverty. Okay, what is poverty? So that's why, according this one, in the rural area, it was 11.2% poverty ratio in Telangana. Okay, 11.2% in rural area in Telangana, and what is called 5% in urban area. The overall it was 8.77%. Overall Telangana. This is about the Telangana. So this much people are there below poverty line, according to Suresh Tendulkar report. But based on this Suresh Tendulkar report, in all India level, it was 25.7% in the rural area. And in the urban area, it was 13.7% in the urban area. And 21.9% is in India. In India. So when comparing with the India level, it will be rural in urban in the total. So Telangana is far better than the India level. So India rural poverty was 25.7, but in Telangana it was only 11.2. In urban India level it was 13.7, but in Telangana it was only 5%. The overall poverty ratio in India it was 21.9%, but in Telangana it was only 8.77%. That is about the Rangarajan, Suresh Tendulkar report. Actually, yesterday I given the Rangarajan report. See, this is the Rangarajan report. So according to the Rangarajan report, he was redefined the monthly per capita expenditure. Monthly per capita expenditure was redefined. Okay, so Suresh Tendulkar 860 suggested, Rangarajan 972 suggested. This is Suresh, this is Rangarajan. This is for rural area. Suresh was suggested 860 rupees monthly per capita expenditure. Rangarajan was suggested 972 rupees for the rural areas. Okay, for the urban area, Suresh was suggested 1009 rupees. He was suggested 407 rupees. Rangarajan suggested 400 rupees. So this is for the urban area. Okay, urban area. Monthly per capita expenditure was suggested Rangarajan. So according to Rangarajan report, those who are not able to spend 972 rupees per month to satisfy his desires, he will come under the below poverty line in the rural areas. So those who are not able to spend 1407 rupees per month to satisfy desires in the urban areas will come under the below poverty line. That is the Rangarajan report. This is the Suresh Tendulkar report. Okay, if you take the Rangarajan report, in Telangana, the poverty ratio was 9.3% in the rural area. In the urban area, it was 11.1%. The total, it was 10% in Telangana. This is what I told you yesterday. According to the Rangarajan committee report, I told you yesterday. So this is the, what is called, in Telangana poverty ratio. So in the India level, rural 30.9%, urban 26.4%, total India it was 29.5%. So this is India level. Okay, rural, urban, total India. So that is total India. So if you see Rangarajan committee report or Suresh Tendulkar report, whatever may be the report, but according to all the reports, Telangana is better than the India level, national level. So in Telangana, standard of living of the people is better than the in all India national level. Okay, that is what we can see when we are talking about this poverty. Okay, this is about the what is called poverty. Okay, that is about the poverty examination. What is poverty? What are the types of the poverty? And what are the methods we are using to estimate the poverty? And what is the latest committee report like Tendulkar committee report and Raghurajan report? And what is the poverty ratio according to these two reports? And what is the monthly per capita expenditure for the rural areas and for the urban areas according to these two committee reports? That is Tendulkar committee report and Rangarajan committee report. Before Rangarajan, before Tendulkar report, there were many committees. Tantwala committee, okay, like Laddawala committee. There were many committees were there. But they are the old committees, you try to remember the new committees. But in 2014, what happened now? So in 2014, when the BJP came to power, so in 2015, immediately, in the place of the planning commission, it was appointed one new organization called Niti Aayog in the place of the planning commission. So this Niti Aayog constituted task force committee in 2015 under the chairmanship of vice chairman of Niti Aayog to construct the new methods, to suggest the new methods to construct the poverty. But of course, till now, the committee was not submitted. So, still, this committee was not submitted report. That's why, what is the latest report? Rangarajan committee report. And Tendulkar committee report. These are the two reports for, you can see, the official report to estimate the poverty. Okay, so that is about the, what is called, poverty. Okay, after the poverty, the next concept is known as the unemployment. What is called unemployment? What is unemployment? So, unemployment may be defined as the situation in which the person is capable of working both physically and mentally on the existing wage rate, but that does not get the employment to work. I think you may have got it. Suppose I am ready to work. Whatever the wages is there in the market, for that I am ready to work. Even though I am ready to work, if the work is not available, then I will be considered as unemployed. So when the people are ready to work physically, mentally, with the existed wages, even the person is ready, but if the person is not able to get the employment, even though he is ready to work, so that situation is known as the unemployment. Okay, a person who is willing to work at the existing wage rate, but does not get the job, then it is called unemployed. Unemployment. It is a situation where we are not able to get the employment, even though we are ready to work. See, for example, mirandaru pani cheyadaniki siddhanga unnaru. కానీ పని లేదు. యూ పీపుల్ ఆర్ రెడీ టు వర్క్ బట్ వర్క్ ఇస్ నాట్ అవైలబుల్. సో దెన్ యూ పీపుల్ విల్ బికమ్ అన్ఎంప్లాయ్డ్. సపోజ్ వర్క్ ఈస్ అవైలబుల్ ఇఫ్ యూ గో టు దేర్ దే ఆర్ రెడీ టు ఎంప్లాయ్ టు యూ యువర్ గివ్ ఎంప్లాయ్ బట్ యు ఆర్ నాట్ విల్లింగ్ టు గో టు వర్క్. అక్కడ పని ఉన్న పని చేయడానికి నువ్వు సిద్ధంగా లేవనుకో, దెన్ యు ఆర్ నాట్ అన్ఎంప్లాయ్డ్. You are called voluntary unemployed. Voluntary unemployed. So this unemployment may be divided into different categories based on the nature of the work. Open unemployment. So this open unemployment may be known as the educated unemployment. The people qualified MBA, BED, PhD. But according to that qualification, the employment work is not there. Actually, suppose you completed MBA, you completed your MBA, but you are working as an attender in some company. Means you are working, you are maybe not unemployed practically, but you did not get the employment according to your education. According to the qualification. According to qualification. That is called open unemployment. Or educated unemployment. Which is called educated unemployment. Disguised unemployment. The people are working without necessary. People are working without requirement. Their additional production is zero. Their marginal production is zero. For example, you take example agriculture. There is a 1 acre of land. 2 people are working. 20 bags you are producing. 20 bags, 20 quintals you are producing paddy. But in the same acre land, 3 people are working. If you one person will be added, is there any chance to increase the production? No. So here, same 20 bags they will produce. So this the third person is not required. Even though not required, he is working because there is no alternative. Since he is not getting any employment in outside, so he is working here. So this is called disguised unemployment. Working, but without work. Working without requirement. So their additional production is nil. Their additional production is zero. So that is called their marginal production. Additional production, nothing but marginal production. Their marginal production is zero. If that is the case, this is not disguised unemployment. Seasonal unemployment. Seasonal unemployment means people will get employment in one season and another season they may not get. Take for example in the rural areas. Most of the people will get the employment during this rainy season because it is harvesting period. During the harvesting period, the people will get the employment. But during the summer, no harvesting activities. That's why no people will get employment in the rural areas during the summer season. So that's why if the people will get the employment based on the seasonality. So that is called seasonal unemployment. And frictional unemployment. Frictional unemployment means whenever the person is changing from one job to another job, during some period you will have some gap in the employment, that is known as the frictional unemployment. For example, I am working in the company here, but I don't want to work in this year. I want to go to another company. So to go to another company, to go to the B company, in between I may be there without employment. Okay, that is known as the frictional employment. So frictional unemployment means when the person is changing from one job to another job, you will get some gap in the employment. So that employment is known as the frictional unemployment. Okay, structural unemployment. Structural unemployment, nothing but whenever the economy is changing, transforming from one sector to another sector, the people who are working in the old sector will be unemployed. See, for example, today education is there. Generally, the teachers will teach, they will get employment. How they will teach? If you people come to me, either college goes there, I got a board with me, they explain yesterday, my class will taro. I will get employment. But today, because of change, all the education was changed towards the online system. Online to Marpe, you got to pay. మీకు ఎవరైతే ఇంత ముందు బోర్డు మీద క్లాస్ చెప్తున్నారో వాళ్ళందరికీ ఇప్పుడు ఎంప్లాయ్మెంట్ లేదు కదా. సో బికాస్ యూ ద యాక్టివిటీస్ వర్ చేంజ్ ఫ్రమ్ ది ఆఫ్లైన్ టు ఆన్లైన్ లైక్ దట్ వెన్ ఎవర్ ద ఎకానమీస్ ట్రాన్స్ఫార్మింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ అగ్రికల్చర్ టు నాన్ అగ్రికల్చర్ దట్ ఈస్ ఇండస్ట్రీ టు వర్క్ ఇన్ ద నాన్ అగ్రికల్చర్ సో దే వాంట్ గెట్ సమ్ క్వాలిఫికేషన్ ఇఫ్ దే డోంట్ హ్యావ్ దట్ మచ్ క్వాలిఫికేషన్ దే విల్ నాట్ గెట్ ఎనీ ఎంప్లాయ్మెంట్ లేదు సింపుల్ గా మీ విలేజ్ లో అగ్రికల్చర్ ఉంది మీకు ల్యాండ్ ఉంది యూఆర్ వర్కింగ్ ఇన్ అగ్రికల్చర్ బట్ అగ్రికల్చర్ ఏరియాలో ఇండస్ట్రీ పెట్టేశారు దట్ మీన్స్ యువర్ ల్యాండ్ ట్రాన్స్ఫార్మ్ టు ఇండస్ట్రీ మరి నువ్వు ఇప్పుడు ఇండస్ట్రీలో వర్క్ చేయాలని నీకు క్వాలిఫికేషన్ ఉండాలి నీకు అర్హత ఉండాలి నీకు ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ ఉండాలి నీకు స్కిల్ ఉండాలి అది లేదు కాబట్టి నీకు తొందరగా లేదు సో లైక్ దట్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ దట్ రీజన్ యూ గాట్ అన్ఎంప్లాయ్డ్ సో దట్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ అన్ఎంప్లాయ్మెంట్ ఈస్ నోన్ యాస్ ది స్ట్రక్చరల్ అన్ఎంప్లాయ్మెంట్ సైక్లికల్ అన్ఎంప్లాయ్మెంట్ ట్రేడ్ సైకిల్ In the trade cycle, we have the economic activities are up and down. So during the trade cycle, if any people will the last employment, so the type of employment is known as the cyclical unemployment and technical I am applying, right? Whenever we are going upgrading towards the technology, the people who are not upgraded technology, so they will lose the employment automatically. So they will be called technical unemployment. So this unemployment is measuring with the different methods, like usual principal status method. Usual principal status. In this usual principal status, the people who are working more than 183 days in a year, they will be employees, otherwise they will be unemployees. More than or equal to 183 days. That means more than half year, 365 days, nothing but 183, nothing but more than half year. Yesterday I told you. So if the person is getting more than 183 or more than 183 days employment in the year, that person is called employed. If the person is not able to get the majority days employment, they will be called unemployed. Okay, they will be called unemployed. Current weekly status. Weekly. So within the week, if the person is not able to get the employment, that is called unemployed. This is not a correct method. The daily method, this is also taking the ratio between the first one and the second one. Okay, in the last week, how many hours he was worked? That hours was converted into for the whole year. When we converted this weekly status unemployment to the whole year, so the person is not able to get the more than 50% days of the employment, so he will be considered as unemployed. So these two methods is not a popular method. The first method is a more important popular method. And after that, current daily status is one of the most popular. And what is the labor force participation rate? Yesterday I told you. Labor force participation rate means the people who are ready to work. The people who are ready to work is known as the labor force. Workforce, nothing but people who are working. Labor force means people who are ready to work. Workforce, nothing but the people who are working. The differences between these two is known as unemployment rate. This is defined as the number of persons unemployed per 1,000 persons in the labor force, that is employed and unemployed. Okay, yeah. Labor force means people ready to work. Workforce, nothing but people who are working. Working, nothing but you can say employees. Unemployed, nothing but the difference between labor force minus workforce. Labor force minus workforce. Unemployment rate, that is labor force minus workforce, divided by labor force into 100. So this is the formula to know the unemployment rate. Labor force minus workforce divided by labor force into 100. So with this formula, we are going to measure the what is called unemployment. Unemployment. So this unemployment rate in India, in Telangana, India, this is the unemployment rate. In Telangana, in 2014-05, in the rural area, unemployment rate was 11.3, urban 7.2, so the total 10.5. But in 2011-12, in Telangana, the unemployment was decreasing. So it was 4 into rural area, 6 in urban area, overall it is 4.7. So unemployment rate was decreased in Telangana from 2004-05 to 2011-12. Employment was generated. Employment was generated not only in the government sector, even the private also, even the agriculture sector also, everything will be considered. If the person is getting the employment more than 183 days, they will be considered as an employment. So the employment was generated in Telangana. So that's why the unemployment was in the degree. So in India level also, this is 2004-05, in rural 8.2, urban 8.3, total 8.2. But in 2011-12, in the rural 5.7, urban 5.5, rural 5.6. But when compared with in 2004-05, when compared with in India level, Telangana, in Telangana region, unemployment rate was more. But when come to 2011-12, when come to India level, it is unemployment rate is less in Telangana than the in all India level. Than the in all India level. So this is the unemployment situation in the country. So these are the some important reasons why there is a poverty, why there is unemployment. It may be in India, it may be Telangana, it may be any state. These are the reasons, because of the population. The population is increasing like anything. When the population is increasing, but the food grains are not increasing. So that's why we are not able to provide all the basic requirements to all the people. That's why poverty is increasing. The population is increasing, the people who are ready to work is increasing, but the government is not able to provide the employment. That's why unemployment is increasing. So the overpopulation is a reason for both poverty and unemployment. So this unemployment causes for the poverty, and poverty is a causes for unemployment. Because of the unemployment, no income. No income, that's why not able to meet the basic requirement. That's why he's called poor people. Because of his poverty, not able to go for the education. So because of the lack of education, lack of skill. Due to lack of skill, not able to get the employment. So that's why employment is the reason for the poverty, and poverty is the reason for the unemployment. And inflation. What is the inflation? Prices are increasing like anything. When the prices are increasing like anything, okay, prices are increasing like anything. So then what we can say, the income level is not increasing for the poor people. That's why when the prices are increasing, but the income level is not increasing, with low level of the income, the people are not able to purchase the goods which they require. That's why they are not able to meet the basic requirement. Since they are not able to meet the basic requirement, that is called poverty. Because of the more inflation, there is a less economic growth. Because of the less economic growth, the rapid industrialization is not taking place. So since there is no industrialization, industrial development is not there, that's why employment is not generated. That's why most of the graduates are coming, but employment is not able to generate. That's why unemployment problem is increasing. So like the illiteracy also one of the most problems. Because of illiteracy, no skill. They don't know how to develop. So they are spending a lot of money on unproductive activities. Most of the people in our country, the poor people particularly, they are spending the lots of money on the unproductive activities. It's simple. It may be sentiment ankochu, but ankochu. Oka pedavadu tan daggara 10,000 vachindi anko, 10,000 చదువుకోవడానికి ఖర్చు పెడితే వాడు డెవలప్ అవుతాడు ఖచ్చితంగా. కానీ ఆ 10,000 వచ్చింది కదా అనేసి పూజ చేస్తే దేవుడు కాపాడదనేసి తను ఉన్నది ఖర్చు పెట్టుకుంటే దేవుడు కాపాడతాడో లేదో తెలుసు, కానీ నువ్వు చదువుకోలేవు, నువ్వు చదువుకోలేకపోతే బాగుపడవు. ఒకటే గుర్తు పెట్టుకోవడం. నాట్ ఓన్లీ నా తెలంగాణ, ఇట్ ఈస్ ద ప్రాబ్లమ్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ పూర్ పీపుల్ ఇన్ ద ఎంటైర్ కంట్రీ. దిస్ ఈస్ వాట్ దే ఆర్ డూయింగ్. ఓకే, యూ మే హ్యావ్ ద సెంటిమెంట్స్, యూ కెన్ స్పెండ్ వెన్ ఆఫ్టర్ ద సాటిస్ఫైయింగ్ యువర్ బేసిక్ రిక్వైర్మెంట్. That is, and gender inequality, differences between ladies and men. Men education is encouraging, but women is not encouraging to work. Most of the women are not working in a country. Working means the productive activities. Productive activities is nothing but income generation activities. They are working in the home, but not in the industries. Not in the productive activities, not in the income generation so activities, and the education system. So in our country, the education system is not also not a professional education. Since it is not a professional education, the people are not able to get the employment. So because of all these reasons, the poverty and unemployment is increasing in the state, in the country. So that's why to reduce this poverty and unemployment only, central government, state governments are taking a lot of activities. Lot of schemes are implementing. Implementing the land reforms, implementing the welfare schemes. Okay, you can write all the schemes which is implemented by our state government to reduce the poverty and unemployment. Okay, if there is any question in the exam, that write the remedial measures to reduce the poverty and unemployment, or the government measures to reduce the poverty and unemployment. You can write 1 rupee kilo PM program. You can write about the Kalyana Lakshmi program. Okay, you can write about the Asara program. Okay, you can write a financial support program. You can write the Pragati Raitu Bandhu program. Like that, there are many schemes, no? So all about all these schemes, so you can write, including land reforms, the distribution of the land for the poor people. Okay, the distribution of the double bed house for the poor people. Okay, everything, all this will come under the poverty and unemployment eradication schemes started and implementing by the state government and central government both. Okay, so this is what we can say about the poverty and what is called unemployment. Okay, so if you want to ask anything, please.
Excuse me, sir. Good afternoon. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, just now you said about causes of poverty and